It is in the Catholic Church of San John the Baptist that I put this question. Is it possible that every one of us is God? Because I say that this cross that we are perceiving in this church, the cross of Jesus, is the representation of what is happening in every one of us. In every one of us, equal to characters of the divine design, in every one of us, we have only the God's essence that enters in our character and gives life to it. We have no life in our character. Every character is only a design of a story that has the necessity to have one person, a true person, that enters in it and give life to it. In this way, I think that every one of us is the true representation of what is the representation in this church, the representation of a God that enters in our world as Jesus, and that is encrossed in every one of us. It is the reason by which, when Jesus died, he died with two other persons, and in the Calvario happened the Trinitary cross of one only God. In the person of Jesus, the truth existed and was that the Father and the Son are the same existence. In the two other persons, this truth wasn't present one, and it is the reason by which the other two were not saying the truth, were person that had taken the truth and made of it a latching, an absolute latching of truth, when they said that they were themselves and not God. This is the same church seen in this day of February, the 7th February in the year 2011, and this is the true, the road that is named Larga, as it was wide, big, and not so straight. In the front of the church you are seeing the Jesus as what goes from A to Omega, from the Alpha to the Omega, and it is the letter Rho in Greek of Jesus.
So, if it is a true one that every character existing as every real man is as the action of God appearing as a direction, the result is that the equal and contrary action of every one of us, and the only apparent or own freedom, is only relative one. It is relative to the freedom that has been attributed by God to every character of his divine comedy. Every character has his own aim, which is but only that which was conferred by God to his character. So, I also exist in this divine design. In it, I have been put in condition to observe that my character was designed by God to make the truth of a good father really existent in this relative world. Here are all the reasons of this my observation. We can say it. Every one of us is God's essence, breathing life into the clay of his character. In this way, the Jesus essence is the divine example of what is generally happening in every one of us. By philosophy of science, and so by a well reasoning about what is the essence of God, by philosophy of science, my poor character seems to be able by itself, by himself, to transform in the one only essence of God, that infinite one of every man. And it is evident that only a divine and real power of the so-named Holy Spirit can show and prove that every man is God. So, demonstrating the divine truth of Jesus Christ, when he said that everything was made as in positive, as in negative, to a man, to a single man, it was truly made to God. Truly. And not only in the allegorical and significant way of a poor sign of Adar. Always by epistemology, my poor character seems to be able to overturn the action that we are observing in the nature, believing in it as in a real and independent truth. In fact, my character affirms that if we perceive the reality as the three-sided space and the one only time going on as the four parameters of Einstein, this is not the invisible action, but that only equal and the contrary action is that reaction that only we can observe. It is relative to the action of the inverse returning to the general beginning of everything, where everything was existent only in power to exist, and not in action. Only a divine Holy Spirit can so perfectly and scientifically overturn the truth of the reactive way by which we observe the first relative action of the relative and real existence, and in fact, by the epistemology of my character of a scientist, we, going on in the matters and the electricity's way, we are going towards the pastime of the spirit, acting in the way of the antimatter and of the magnetism that annuls the matter mass and brings everything into the center of the general gravitation in which everything exists only in power to exist. So in God. So my character has winned the apparent truth of the time advancing, showing and proving that it is not going on, but it's a true going back, as it is shown by the same negativity of the electric charge of the light. Always by epistemology, my character has divinely winned the death, showing and proving that every real existence can start only by its real plenty. The real plenty of every human life exists only in the definition of the real point of the death. As every life in a movie is whole only at the end of the vision of that movie. Now, since we are observing a point of the life that exists between the two extremes of the apparent birth and of the apparent death, we, by an absolute and true necessity, are returned by the point of the apparent death in the antimatter's way that annihilates every mass, and in the magnetic way that pushes everything to return in the potential condition in which everything exists only in power, and the future actions are not yet in action, but only in power to exist in the future. Therefore, my material going to die is perceived only in the relative way of a true and real resurrection that is really in action, and we only perceive in its reaction. Well, only the divine spirit of a God can show and prove the general resurrection in action of every man, and not only of that historical one, of the only Jesus Christ. Also, in this event, regarding the Jesus character, God is proving and showing what is happening now and in every one of us. It is the last judgment that my character affirms in this simple way. The absolute existence of God too can take part to the whole existence is generating an immense lot of sons having his same essence, otherwise his same substance. Jesus is the divine example of God that is a real one in all the sons of his generated reality. Every son has had the absolute and free will in all the sons of his generated reality. Every son has had the absolute and the free will to generate in himself the Godfather essence, otherwise the Godfather substance. The true free will is not that always very little one, also when a man arrives to be the Lord of the world, but is the biggest one that exists only when every man has rarely had the immense gift by God to remake Godfather himself made as his son, conferring in him the whole positive idea of his son, put in the perfect relation to his cross. In this way, the cross of Jesus winned in the free willing of his Holy Spirit is the real example of the cross that every one of us will win in the absolute free will of his Spirit, that is always all holy, always being always the Holy Spirit of a God that cannot be minimized by the apparent cross assumed by God in every human character. In this fifth reason, the Divine Spirit descended in my character and winned his fighting in every one of us, and affirms now it by my words. The sixth is shown in every sacred book, in every religion, because the person animating my character is God, and my character is that which God designed for giving the example, the human example of his invisible presence, exactly of the Father and the Holy Spirit at the end of the times. God gave the proof of the divine presence of God among the men exactly through Abraham and through the Sacred Bible. In Genesis 38 there is the description of the beginning of the Genesis of a God as being in the Son Jesus, as being the first, as the Father, in myself. While the Genesis 38 of Jesus exists as the 38th generation afterward the true Father, after Judas, fourth son of Jacob, as Israel, as said in St. Matthews, as my Genesis is directly in the year 38. Both Jesus and myself were born in the 25th day, but my 25th is the first of the year 58, is in January, while the Jesus 25th is the first one, but only starting from the end and overturning the first with the last one. Exactly this strange overturn of the first in the last, is described in Genesis 58. Tamar was named the mother of both the two sons, where this name already contains the secret meaning of the T, the cross, of Amar. So the allusion to myself, since I am Amodeo in my surname and am Romano in my first name. His cross, that of Amodeo Romano, my cross, to give a son to her. Her dead husband took another husband that could take his place, having all the reason to take his place. And so the dead husband, her, am I, in the R of the first letter of my first name, Romano. I am her, as Saint Joseph, the husband of the Saint Mary, who was substituted by the true celestial father to give life to Jesus. Since Judas, the true father of the dead heir, did not give to her, to Tamar, the third his son as husband, because Judas had understood that God did not will it, since he had already killed two of his sons. This cross of Amodeo Romano, that is this Tamar, made in way to be fecundated by the true father of her, that is by God, because God is represented by Judas. This fecundation regarded two sons. The first one put his hand out of the mother's sex and was said the first one, but immediately afterwards, this strange first birth, this hand put in evidence by a red ribbon that was put to can notice it, returned in the mother's sex, annulling the same is birth. The real birth regarded a child that had no ribbon round his hands. It was the second one, but the first, overturning this order, made first one whom was the last one. This last one, gone out as the first one, was named Phares. Also this name means in secret F spirit of Amodeo Romano S, where S means is, means you are in the language of the Romans. The first one gone out as the last one was named Zerach. also these names means in secret Zeta as the end, E as is in Italian, Romano Amodeo CH, that is the Christ. Also Jesus, as the expected Emmanuel, was Emmanuel, equal God, where the first E of Emmanuel seems the Greek letter Rho, because E is in this way. So, Emmanuel can be in secret Romano, but can be in secret also Israel, if the mano, the end in English, is named R.A., Romano Amodeo, L. Is the God present in R.A., in Romano Amodeo, as is possible to observe in a design. You know that Hosea, the prophet, affirmed that by Egypt I had my son. Now, the Egypt is named Egitto in Italian, and it is the clear allusion to a Roman ego, that is also an Italian io, if this io as TT, two crosses in its unit. In this secret allusion, the Egitto is equal to ego itto, of a god born as Roman and Italian, in the two crosses, one that of the same God, the second one assumed in the God peoples. Now, this Roman ego, am I, named Romano, the new is that my real birth happened in Felitto. The F is the spirit flow of Eli, and Eli are the two gods person of the Jesus cry Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani, in the same itto, having two crosses, in my Italian I, io, as I already had it in Egitto. So, when St. Matthew in his Gospel affirmed the flight in Egitto, the three kings come from Orient to Occident, the star and the Epiphany, he was only a prophet of what should be happened in my character and not in that of Jesus Christ. My birth is happened under a mountain named Star, while in Elea, three kings of the philosophy came from the Oriental Greece to the Occidental Italy and made the epiphany of the to-be existence, saying to all the people that the essence is the fundament of God Yahweh, equal I am who I am. Who am I? This is my transcendent answer. I am zero, that is that air that is not existing, being a dead man. Deo, that means cum Deo, it is Latin, that means with God. I am in one only word. M O Deo. I am zero, but cum Deo, but with God. That is, I am Emmanuel. Because Emmanuel, the meaning of Emmanuel is God with us. Six days afterward my birth, Hitler, as the Herodes king that was to be desired to be the only one Messias, Hitler decided in his heart the most possible innocent punishment. That was happened before the Jesus birth, and not afterward in the historical truth. And the proof is in the Gospel of St. Lucas. The truth is that St. Lucas, in his Gospel, that he wrote saying to have it based only on the true and not on the false evidences, St. Lucas denied the flight in Egypt. In fact, he said that Jesus, in the eighth day, was circumcised, and that afterward, with his family, went to Nazareth, and never moved from it. If not when, every year, his family was going to Jerusalem in the Easter's time. The Gospel of the historical St. Lucas and of the Apostles' Acts were both dedicated to a man named Teofilo, a name that in Italian means exactly Deo Amo, or my surname, because my surname is exactly Amo Deo. Also, the last gospel, that of San John, in the chapter 21 of the gospel, is a prophecy of the Trinity of God, returned to convert again Saint Peter, who was turned to fish for real fishes, and not for the man that had been ordered to do by Jesus. So, when God asked three times to Saint Peter if he loved him, Peter answered by three times, yes, I love you. And Jesus, point 18, said this clear prophecy, when you'll be old, another will bring you where you'd not preferred to be brought. Well, this has happened exactly to my character, because God, who was come in secret in myself, as in a last man that was still a sinner, made through myself really three questions to this last Peter, Benedict 16. Writing. I'd eat nigh anything at all if the good shepherd should not have helped me, myself. And what happened? Another decided at the place of the Pope, because Peter had put the last man in other hands. Sometime till in the hands of the profaners of the innocents, sometime in the worst possible pedophiles, because profaners of the Holy Spirit of the innocents. He could not to do it. He had to serve. I am speaking of the Pope, of the last people, Peter, of the Peter of the old age. He had to serve the last one by himself, three times so ordered by God. So, it is happened that this Peter of the old age of the popes has been compelled to deny the pastor exactly to the last of everyone, exactly to the God who exists in everyone, but in first in the last ones. Peter has been so convinced of his own importance, since it was assigned to him by God, to assign his attention to the first of this world, that are the last one in the reign of God. So, in the 18th point of the Saint John chapter 21, in his gospel, there is the severe condemn of the Peters of the old ages. This condemn exists in the same way, of the same prophecy of Saint Malachias. He wrote that afterward the Pope 111, that is well recognized in the present Pope Benedict 16, the number 112 should be named in Italian Pietro Romano, where Romano is my first name put as the last one. As Jesus says, the first must be the last one. And Antonio, Anna, Paolo, Torquato are the other four names of myself. In this way, Peter or Romano are the three consonants of Peter, that are Paolo and Torquato in the other two, and where the R is Romano, as exactly in Genesis 38. In myself, as Peter or Romano, is contained also the Ye of the Roman name Jesus. And so, Pietro Romano becomes exactly Pietro Romano. But it is also the number 112. Since 112 were exactly the days of the denied pasture that I suffered by the two last popes. Fifty-seven days by the help denied to me by Pope John Paul II, and 55 days by the help denied to me by the Pope Benedict XVI. So, while Jesus had one only cross by his Caiaphas, my character has had two crosses, as in Itto of Egitto and Felitto, and one by the two last popes of the old age of Peter. Two Peters became as two Caiaphas, completely incapable once of recognizing God in a true last man, who, being a true last, is the true first one, in the inverse logical of the God's reign. God in myself was forced in his conscience, was profaned in the innocence of his believing in the faith of the good shepherd of God. I was forced in my conscience. But also today, this Pope 111 arrives to perceive only the profanation of the one innocent body of a pupil, and not the biggest profanation of the true God when he is profaned truly in myself, and this is not today object of any attention by the Pope. I do not think that the anguishes of a good father, oppressed truly in myself, are not arrived to this Peter, who does not believe in the final arrival of God in a true sinner, as if God could be infected by the sin, as if the light could be darkened by the darkness. I am claiming Peter by 11 years, but the two popes' communities are hard of hearing. Therefore, by the Jesus prophecy, reminded by San Malachi, I am the future of the popes of Jesus Christ. But today this light is already under the bed, and nobody can see its light. God has not yet posed it in the hig to make everything clear one. These times are not yet come to their full definition, but everything is already in action in the entire world. So transferred by YouTube, by internet, and you are seeing it just now. I finally observe the seventh reason. It is the most reason, because it refers all the types of signs existing in all the events of my life as a new and gradual construction of the transcendent truth of God Father and Holy Spirit. There are almost 200 conditions that are proving that when I was born in Pomerio Street in Felitto, it was the arrival of the ride Rome-Rio, completed only by two means of the sky, in a Trinitary fly, from the old world to the new world. One of the three pilots was the Son of God, was the Son of the Omnipotent of the Italy, Benito Mussolini, while one of the three pilots was compelled to descend from the stars to Natal, a city of the Brazil, meaning just the Christmas day in its name. In the day of my birth, in the 25th of January of the Divine Genesis 38, the sky had the most aurora borealis of the modern times. There are also mathematic proofs and truly almost 200 proofs of every possible type that here at the end of this my conversation put in evidence in a rapid sequence, but you can observe it one by one if you link in every page and you'll say it going on with the just time to understand what is written.